If you handle any accounting processes in NetSuite, then you understand how critical accounting periods are to a company's finances. With NetSuite's accounting periods feature, you have access to everything you need to set up and use accounting periods. In this video, we're going to get an overview of accounting periods and walk through the process of setting them up and using them on transactions. Let's get started. First, what exactly are accounting periods? Accounting periods are a defined span of time used to group and organize a company's financial transactions. They allow you to control when transactions post to the GL. Without accounting periods, transactions will automatically post to the GL in real time. But with the accounting periods feature in NetSuite setup, you can select which accounting period each transaction posts in. The accounting periods feature also provides reporting on periods and a simplified closing process at the end of each period. Before using accounting periods, you'll need to set them up. To do that, you'll need to do three steps. Enable access to accounting periods, create fiscal calendars, and create new periods. To enable access to accounting periods in your NetSuite account, log in to NetSuite as the administrator and navigate to Enable Features. Here, you'll find the accounting periods feature under the Basic Features section of the Accounting tab. Check the box and save the page to turn on this feature. Next, you'll need to create fiscal calendars, although technically this is optional. You can create fiscal calendars only if you have the Multiple Calendars feature enabled, and this feature is available only for accounts with NetSuite OneWorld. But assuming that you do have NetSuite OneWorld, that you have enabled multiple calendars, and that you do want to use fiscal calendars, you would do that by navigating to Setup, Accounting, Manage GL, Fiscal Calendars, New. On this page, you'll name the calendar, choose the first month for that fiscal calendar, and determine whether or not this will be the default fiscal calendar. When a calendar is the default, new fiscal years and periods will automatically be created according to this fiscal calendar, though of course you would always have the option of switching the fiscal calendar manually. Now it's time to create new periods. You can do this from the Manage Accounting Periods page, which you can access by navigating to Setup, Accounting, Manage GL, Manage Accounting Periods. On this page, you can either create a single accounting period at a time, or you can create all the accounting periods in a single fiscal year. By far, the quickest method would be to create an entire fiscal year at once. Let's look at an example. We want to set up the fiscal year with all its periods for 2024. We have four quarters in the fiscal year with three periods in each quarter, each representing a single month. On the Manage Accounting Periods page, select the button Set Up Full Year. This will take you to the Accounting Periods for Full Year page. Here, you'll choose the fiscal calendar you will be using for this year, and the format of the period, either in months, 4 weeks, etc. The fiscal year end field allows you to choose the year this fiscal year will apply to. In our example, we would enter 2024 in this field. The year in period name dropdown allows you to determine which year the period will be named by. If your fiscal calendar begins in January and runs through December of a single calendar year, then the content of this field is irrelevant. If, however, your fiscal year begins in one calendar year and ends in the next year, then you'll need to decide whether to name the period by the beginning year or the ending year. After entering this information, select Save. Instantly, you have an entire year set up, including its quarters and individual periods. Another way to create periods is to create them individually rather than all at once. To do this, you would need to create each year, quarter, and period separately. That's what the New Year Only, New Quarter Only, and Base Period buttons at the top of the page allow you to do. If you decide to go this route, you'll want to make the year first, then the quarters, and then the individual periods. This is important because on the quarter setup page, you'll need to choose which year the quarter belongs to, and on the period setup page, you'll need to choose which quarter the period belongs to. The end result, however, is going to be essentially the same as the option for setting up the full year. The main use case for setting up your periods individually would be if you have complicated quarters and periods that don't fall neatly into specific weeks or months. So far, we've seen an overview of what accounting periods are and how to create them in NetSuite. You've also gotten a bit of an idea of what the Manage Accounting Periods page looks like. Let's quickly walk through everything we're seeing here on this page. We've already explained the use of all the buttons at the top, except for Close Multiple Periods, but we'll be looking at that in another video. Directly under the buttons, there are a couple different filter options. If you use multiple accounting books and multiple fiscal calendars, you can use this filter region to select which accounting book and which fiscal calendar you wish to view. In the list of accounting periods, you'll notice that you can collapse all the quarters and periods to just display the fiscal years. Alternatively, expanding a fiscal year will display the associated quarters and periods. There are also expand all and collapse all buttons. And to view either a fiscal year, quarter, or period, select its name. Now, let's look at all the columns following the period names. Notice that each period has a checklist icon in the checklist column. Selecting this icon will take you to a page detailing all the tasks that are necessary to close that period. This checklist will help you stay on track when closing periods, ensuring that you don't miss any essential closing steps. Back on the Manage Accounting Periods page, if you see a green check mark next to a period in the Period Close column, that tells you that all the period close tasks have been completed and the period has been closed. When a period is closed, the AP transactions, AR transactions, and all GL transactions columns will display an orange lock. This icon communicates that all these types of transactions have been locked in these periods and cannot be edited by users who don't have advanced permissions. And if there is a checkmark in the column Allow Non-GL Changes, that means users can still edit non-posting transactions in this period. Now we've seen what accounting periods look like once they've been neatly closed and all the related transactions have been locked away. But how do you connect transactions to accounting periods in the first place? To connect a transaction to a particular accounting period, you'll select the appropriate period using the Posting Period field. This field will display a drop-down of all the periods that are open, whether they are past, present, or future periods. It's important to note, however, that you won't find a Posting Period field on non-posting transaction forms. In fact, if you're curious about whether or not a transaction will post the GL, the presence or absence of the Posting Period field on a transaction is a pretty good giveaway. So, for example, you won't be able to connect a purchase order to a specific posting period. A vendor bill, on the other hand, is definitely a posting transaction and would have a Posting Period field. And that's a wrap on the basics of accounting periods in NetSuite. Keep an eye out for our next video where we'll cover some accounting period FAQs, including things like how to edit, delete, close, or reopen accounting periods. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.